Hey everyone, Happy New Year! Perhaps you'll recall that last June I did a challenge called June Tunes, the product of which was 8 8-bit covers uncovered, which you can listen to right now for free on Bandcamp. I'm doing it again for this year, calling it Jamuary in the month of January. I currently have 12 songs that I need to cull down once again to 8. Let me know in the comments which ones you like, which ones you didn't, and that way I can make the favorite 8 what they're going to be for the end of the month. All right, first off, we have Hard Times by Paramore, recommended to me in the comments last year. Here it is, my rendition in 8-bit. Alright, here's Mr. Brightside, and I've got just a very simple loop at the beginning showing what this melody might sound like in 8-bit. Alright, here's Feel Good Inc., pretty popular one, pretty well known. Right there, that makes a pretty nice loop. Tell me what you think. I think you can tell when a song is going to make a good 8-bit when just the melody works no matter what, in any genre. The original's fantastic. I think it's going to land in 8-bit as well. Alright, here's Breeze Blocks. I think you'll get the feel for the song if you haven't heard it pretty quick. Scissors in your fevers, greet me again. Never kisses, or do you ever send a full star? Do you know? So it's got that energy, that kind of slower, smoother motion with the chop, 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 chop at the end of each phrase. And that's what I have here. All right, this might be the most famous one of the group. This is Enemy. It was played on the show Arcane. Alright, so here comes Still Feel by Half Alive, a huge favorite song of mine. I love this band, and unfortunately, I think what they're doing in the original will be very hard to transfer to 8-bit. I think you'll see what I mean pretty quickly here. When I'm furthest from myself, feeling closer to the stars, I've been in vain. And here comes mine. So you can see I've already started adding some flourish to it. This bass section is just really hard to do right, I think. Poppies, by this very small artist, King David. You go to his channel, it's like, I don't know, he's like put out 12 songs ever, and the last one was 3 years ago, so the melody is exactly the type of stuff I want to write. This is the type of stuff I would make from my own brain. Okay, so if I could dare make a little note here, I haven't even done that high voice, that like whistle type thing. I've just got the bass and the kind of main melody. I also let the drums kind of go off because there's a lot of goofy stuff going on in the drums, and here it is. A little messed up. June's the artist. It's really distinct. I'm a huge fan of it, and I think I've done a very good job of replicating it. This demo is a little longer because I got the intro and like the first lap through the verse. You'll see what I mean pretty quick. Alright, so you got a feel for what the vocals look like when they come in. Give this a chance. I just feel like this song was begging to be moved to 8-bit, that the way the low voice and the high voice kind of do like a little bouncy thing here. All right, this will be the second song by Aurora that I've covered. The first one was Cure For Me. This one from 6 years ago is the first song I ever heard by her. I think it's amazing. If you want to hear more, you should go Google it yourself, because that's about as much as I covered, starting with the drums on their own. Alright, here's another one, Monster by Doty.
Tell me again about how it hurts being awfully loud for an introvert.
Okay, with this one, I took a little bit of creative license. I originally heard this song. I know it's crazy. Super popular song. 13 years ago, plenty old. I heard it for the first time in the show Westworld, which had like a really cool orchestral cover of it. I was like, whoa, this is crazy. And then I Googled the original song. It's also very, very good. If you haven't heard it before, let's just do a little demo. I'm a big fan of how well that loops. All right, rounding out the 12 is another Goblin Hovel piece. I did one by them for the first album called I Give You the Soil, which I had a personal connection to. I wanted to give this band more love. Look at this. This is someone else posting the song. 4 likes, 158 views. This is super small. Pretty simple melody, it's fun to turn folk into 8-bit. Tell me what you think. And that's it, folks. Those are the 12. I'll make things as easy as possible. I'll have something up on screen here with all of the names and numbers. Here's my own channel. Hey, check out that temporary banner, a sign of what's to come. But then when it comes to comments, Aaron, my good friend, kind of wins the award of leaving the most comments behind, which is fantastic. I'm very happy about that. I don't get too many comments, but I get quite a few, and that makes me happy. But forever ago, here we go, Hard Times by Paramore. This comment dropped like midway through June, so I wanted to give this one special credit. This is the only song that was ever commented. I'm looking forward to a good January as I throw this together and pick an album title and album art. I'm also going to put out at least a few videos talking about the process, just like in June Tunes. So if there's any part of the process you're interested in, please let me know and I will make that happen. If we sort by views, I believe still, yeah, check this out. These three videos were related to June Tunes and they were my most popular by far, which is why I'm still doing this in the new year. I'm trying to change the mood of the channel. That'll be more obvious in February, but I think there's no surprise that making the music was pretty popular, although this ties many motorways. But the two videos where I talk about how I did it, I talked about the tool for only 5 minutes, 278, pretty good. And I did just a full demo of making a beat. I don't know if having Hollow Knight there in the thumbnail made it better, but also the huge red arrows, it's so dumb and goofy. I have no complaints, I love doing this. So thanks again for watching. End of January, we're gonna have another album. It might be a little like this one. It'll have the same artist doing the cover, which is a lot of fun. And it will end up on Bandcamp. The Bandcamp's still here, it'll be linked in the description. Jimmy Johan, that is my music handle. Okay, thanks so much for your time. Please leave comments, make your voice heard for the album. Thanks.